both very tired this morning, and we got up and we rushed so that we were out and in the car as quick as possible. We had to take the car to get the windscreen repaired.
There's some woman in the water, and look, just to give you an idea, this is how Elena's dressed. Water skiing. So it's the cable what takes them around, and then they do all the jumps and all that kind of stuff.
So I drove off, and I had to put the window up. It was a windy window, but I was talking to somebody. So I was driving, and I wound the window up at the same time as I revved off, but my head was out of the window. So I literally, I drove off, and my fucking head stuck out of the window like that.
And this is the big donut on a stick.
Yeah,
get out the way, Eleanor. Yet. You're right in the way, yeah, Eleanor.
You can't see anything anyway now.
It's coming down. Eleanor hasn't eaten for 3 hours since she got home.
This is open. I can see lights. Look, Anna.
Let's go to a main street, and then we're going to have to get a cab back because my legs are a mess. Ooh, I want candy.
Sweet job.
The toilet flush stopped working, the fire stopped working, and Eleanor stopped working. Well, at least she didn't cost much to get fixed.
Exactly.
Yeah, cheap.
We've arrived in Climping, and that's the real name, by the way.
It's not Climping.
It's not Climping.
And it's not Nepal.
No, I had to explain it to her in the car because she was like, what are you talking about? I mean, this lady's so innocent, you wouldn't believe.
Aren't I? Ragazzi, dovete per forza venire qua. Siamo venute qua per vedere pulire.
What?
Oh, it's a bit cold.
Yeah, very. 5 months.
We're going for a walk. Dog garden. It's a dog training area. Here, he gets you. This is my last day on the campsite. No more worthing for a while.
So I'm going to say goodbye to this dog walking area. I'm so bored of it. I've been here so many times.
In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the lion sleeps tonight.
Topic. So there you go. Fibers, what look like hair, what you sprinkle into the root, brush through, the lids just drop right off. So I'm going to tap it right in, and you can be the judge of this. You have to brush the fibres in through the hair. It should be looking a little thicker. And does it look thicker, or does it look exactly the same, and have I just wasted £6.95?
It's the 4th of November, and there are fireworks outside, and Belle is really not liking it. I gave her a herbal pill. I don't think it's helped at all, in the slightest.
Jack, are you really scared of the fireworks? Are they really bothering you?
Ow! She's bit my lip, she didn't care. I don't know if it's because she's a gun dog, or she's deaf, or she just doesn't really care. Either way, I'm quite happy.
Moving day! Got to pack up all the stuff into the caravan. And then hook up the car and take the caravan. Ow! Oh, she's so short. Those nails. Oh. She's so annoying.
I'm a little sad to be leaving this place, but
I'm looking forward to going to the next place.
Right, if you want to see what a caravan looks like when it's full of, well, my crap, should I say, I will show you.
Look at that rubbish. That is full of crap, what we've been using over the past 6 months or so. See, and that's John. That's John's bottom. And as you can see, it's quite nicely formed.
See, we're on our last leg now. We're just about to zoom off. I'm putting some air in the caravan tires. And then, yeah. If any of you have wondered what it's like to pull a caravan, well, I will tell you, it is very nerve-wracking to some extent. You can feel it behind you, and it kind of like keeps pushing into the car, and obviously the revs on the car have to be really, really high. But once you're on the road, as long as you give yourself a couple of foot either side, and remember how long you are, because this train is really, really long compared to driving a normal car, you'd be all right. I successfully arrived in Alderstead Heath campsite. So right behind us, this is directly behind the caravan, is like a woody area. This is good because then the doggies can go and poo. Now, what I'm gonna try and do, if I can, is I'm gonna try and put up this porch awning. This is really difficult. It's like every time I keep hitting one of these pegs and they keep breaking off, I'm gonna have to get some more pegs and another hammer. That's what I'm hitting the pegs in with. It doesn't work. There is one great thing about this particular campsite. The walking, dog walking area and the little cycle area is so close. I've got a problem with my dropper seat for some reason. It's staying down. I think it's because when Elena was on this bike, she had it on the lowest setting, so something's gone a bit weird with it. So I've kind of fixed it. It's working a bit slower than it did last time. Woo woo! Don't cycle with one hand while cycling with dogs. This is what they call the dog walking area at the caravan club at Alderstead Heath. And it is huge. It is a little wood within itself. And it would take about, I don't know, 3/4 an hour to walk around, and then you've got all the little lanes and tracks going in and out of the place. It's magnificent, and the dogs really, really do enjoy it. This is how good my dogs are. They just sit and then move about 3 seconds after I tell them to sit. Colston Church is so cool, it's really sweet. It's very plain inside. Right, I've done, I'm gonna head back.
Come on. Don't die, John. Okay. Entering the haunted wood. Come on, Jack. Is this wide enough for my bike? Woohoo! Just. This at the bottom, Daniel came off the bike twice. Ow! Squirrel! Oh my god, that's muck all up my bike, I bet. This site is considerably bigger than the other one. And the caravans are a little bit close together for my liking, but I don't seem to hear anybody. Here we are. Caravan, sweet caravan.
Whilst I love listening to the rain gently beat down on the top of the caravan, it's 6 o'clock in the morning. I must have been woken up like 4 or 5 times because it was pelting it down last night. Hello, YouTube. If you too would like your hair to look like a demented cockatoo in the morning, comment below and buy me a bacon sandwich. It's pouring.
It's time for bed now, so I'm going to take my 1, 2, 3, 4 steps. I'm in bed and that's it. That didn't take a lot, did it? Oh, surprise, surprise. There you go, Jack. Daniel's coming tomorrow, so he'll be here about 1 o'clock, which is really cool. And he's going to bring a hammer. And he's going to bring himself. I'm going to get some food and maybe a bottle of wine. And yeah, should have a nice weekend.